8 wins in their last 10 games, included in there a 7-game win streak. But this road trip has not been kind to them. They've dropped 2 of the first 3 on the trip. Battle along the wall in the offensive zone for Minnesota. Foligno out front, just out of the reach of Cunnan. Erickson Eka shot. Foligno jamming away. And Markstrom's able to make the save. Not surprising to see Foligno in the blue paint for Minnesota.
Time high from a turnover behind the net. That's where this all started. We talked about pressuring the defensemen of the Vancouver Canucks, a team that has played, again, 4 games in 6 days. Outnumbered their opponent around the front of the net.
Dubnyk out to play it for Minnesota. Brodin off the wall. Horvat has Parisi tied up. Stetcher a long shot. That's deflected into the corner by Dubnyk. And then a stick save by Dubnyk on a shot by Edler. But they were unable to close the gap on the Flames. Here's a sliding save by Dubnyk on a close range chance by JT Miller.
For the challenger, wrist shot on net, trying to find it. Squirts over to the other side. Pushes with his left pad to get over.
Pattern wraps it back down low. Fiala works past Hughes. Fiala cuts to the middle. Soucy got a piece of it. Koivu a shot. Saved by Markstrom.
By the Minnesota Wild. The Vancouver Canucks.
Here they have a chance coming the other way, but the shot is gloved by Dubnyk. Stahl slammed into the boards by Edler. Stahl maintains the puck, then has it knocked away. And the Canucks come out with Bertanen. Jake Vertanen around Dumba. Blows into the zone. Dubnyk with a save. And then the rebound knocked away. And we're going to get a goaltender interference penalty against Antoine Roussel to Hartman. Hartman tried to force it down to the corner. Now got it back to Dumba. Dumba with a shot right on and a save by Markstrom.
Getting pucks and players to inside ice.
Penalty coming here against Minnesota. Horvat in on the attack, fires, saved by Dubnyk, and Brodin just able to knock it away from Besser, and the penalty is going to go against Greenway for elbowing. He was tangled up back in the Vancouver zone.
Minnesota penalty number 18.
That range, and then a nice save here on a 2-on-1. Bo Horvat is the heart and soul.
Miller works up high. JT Miller looks, gives to Hughes, or to Pettersson rather, for a shot. Dubnyk with a save there. Hughes now battling along the end wall. Sell jumps out of the box. It's a 7-second two-man advantage, but he'll head straight to the bench. Pettersson with it, looking, fires, save Dubnyk. Koivu's back on. Now it's 5-on-4 for a minute 20.
He's outstanding. There's not much that this guy doesn't do. He's a tremendous, tremendous skater and comes up the ice like he's been playing forever. That's that nice little play over there to Pettersson. That was from...
Back to the line, Myers. Good stick by Greenway, knocks it away. A dozen seconds left in the power play. Vertanen winds and fires, save Dubnyk. And the rebound cleared by Soucy. And Minnesota's penalty killer is a perfect 3-for-3. Garello up high, Dumba. Across Suter. Roussel's back on. Zuccarello, a deflection. And Parisi couldn't find the rebound.
Okay, this is the chance in front. Great save by Markstrom, clearing the puck there.
Blatant cross check to the ribs. Well, we play on, and now the Canucks are on the power play again. Hughes with a shot, and they score. It deflects by Dubnyk on the way in. Mentioned Hughes and his power play assist earlier. This will be another one. And the Canucks, with a power play tally, lead it 1-0.
Chen down to the front of the net. Has unbelievable hands passing and can score. Gets his stick on this puck and redirects it back through Devin Dubnyk's foot. Jonas Brodin, I think, thought someone was coming to the net on the back door and didn't have a stick to inside ice. And as much offense as you would like, especially with having Jason Zucker back in the lineup. They got all their soldiers back in the lineup right now.
Schaller with a sharp angle shot. I'm sure that's the frustrating part as a skilled player, is when you're the victim of something like that from a guy everybody knows does it. How about this by Marcus Foligno? Driving to the net, and he scores on the rebound. Minnesota ties it.
Maybe the referee calls a penalty. A lot of gets inside position on Brock Besser. Yes, he does spit out a rebound, Markstrom. And Marcus Foligno, because he's going to the net and he's got his mind set up, he knows Cunning's going to get the puck to the net. He's not able to handle it and gets rewarded for doing a great job of getting to the paint. And what a huge goal for the Minnesota Wild here to tie this game up in the second period.
Among 3 Calgary defenders and would not be stopped on the way to the net. Another one here from the blue paint, and Minnesota has tied it. Now the Canucks have broken the tie. As Dubnyk has it flipped over his shoulder from close range, and just like that, Vancouver's back in front by one.
So in a while, again, getting pucks in the net, that's how most of the goals are scored in the National Hockey League. The Vancouver Canucks just throw the puck on net, goes off Matt Dumba's stick. Devin Dubnyk cannot swallow up the rebound on the deflection, doesn't know exactly where it is. It hits him in the helmet, and Jonas Brodin just could not get to that loose puck.
Battle in the corner, JT Miller has it for the Canucks. He's defended by Suter, plays it back to the line, and a long shot, they score. Stetcher beats Dubnyk over the shoulder, and the Canucks extend the lead to 3-1.
Watch the spinorama to his forehand, able to create a little separation underneath Ryan Suter's stick. Marcus Foligno slid down on the back door.
Wilder back at full strength, and Zucker just out of the box takes the feed from Hartman. Hartman driving the net back to Greenway, and Markstrom makes the save.
What a save by Markstrom. Outstanding play by Jason Zucker.
Minnesota back at full strength, but still trailing 3-1. Suter hammers one toward the net. Foligno in the blue paint again, but he could not get a stick on the puck. Canucks clear. It'll be icing against Vancouver.
It's that puck come to the front of the net. The rebound come back out his way right here. Yes, he does get a great shot away. Able to find the puck. Markstrom, Mikko Koivu. Their last shift was outstanding. Let's see if they can back that up with another good one here.
Zuccarello centers Parisi. And a save by Markstrom. He's had two good looks here lately, but Minnesota's still down 3-1. Down there by Dumba, but he put it right on the stick of JT Miller. Miller across for Pettersson, a shot off the post. Rebound controlled by Dumba. Fiala back to Dumba. His shot blocked on the way. Dumba able to hold the zone and sprawls to keep it alive. Zucker with it. Zucker moves in. Centers and stalls, denied by Markstrom.
Position. Great second effort. Jason Zucker looking on the back door. This is the first unbelievable side to side.
Out to Dumba. Back stall. Stall moves in. Fiala with it. Dumba drive. Save Markstrom. Zucker on the rebound. And then Cunnan denied by Markstrom.
On Eric Stahl again. Shot on the net. Looking for the rebound. Jason Zucker does a great job. Gets it on net. And his ability to recover with his blocker on the second shot.
There for Minnesota. Suter knocks it down and holds. Zucker trying to go back to Parisi. He's pinched off the puck. Centering pass. And Stahl is denied by Markstrom again. And Zuccarello back to retrieve the loose puck. Finds Stahl at center. Stahl into the offensive zone. Waiting, got Schaller to go down. Zuccarello back from Spurgeon. A shot and a glove saved by Markstrom. Spurgeon in the corner. Horvat able to clear. Soucy races back. And the puck curves in for an empty net goal. And Horvat makes it 4-1 Vancouver. And the Wild will suffer another defeat against a team they're chasing in the standings.
They played last night. They got a big win against yesterday afternoon. Got a big win against the Buffalo Sabres. Were able to buckle down defensively. Knew that they were tired. They knew their goaltender was going to have to make some big saves down the stretch. But for the Minnesota Wild, that was a very, very important game that they lost here this afternoon. They're going to have to regroup as they head out to Pittsburgh here in a couple days.